You need to test in the process that young women in some churches and cultures go through on a monthly basis. It is in some cases performed by girls' mothers, aunties, or prospective husbands to check for an intact hymen.
We think that that whole process of virginity testing, it affects a lot of things. It removes your right to privacy and bodily integrity, and it also is really humiliating. Imagine having someone, you know, placing their fingers into your private
part. This process is believed by some, especially older women, to be a way of protecting their daughters against abusive husbands.
No kind of woman, Vana. Mukango tadzirana chete zvinhu zvidikidiki. Murume achakudza kuti ndosaka ndakakuroora uri mvana.
Dzimwe nguva anenge akuzofunga kuti kunzoko usati akuroora vanhu vangana vakarara navo zvinhu zvinenge zvakumunetsa saka zvinhu zvinenge zvakuita kuti chii akutukirire. Saka ini aithingi kuti nyaya yekutestwa kwevasikana iri necessary.
When has being a virgin been ever a shield against domestic violence or gender-based violence? There's no evidence actually to point out or even prove that if you're married a virgin, it's going to shield you from an abusive husband.
Surprisingly, there are no laws in Zimbabwe that specifically prohibit such a practice that is said to deprive women of their right to body ownership, among other rights.
We still have a lot to do as civil society. There's still a gap in the pieces of legislation, and I think it's our role as women's rights activists, as individual activists even, to advocate for the introduction of legislation that specifically prohibits this thing called virginity testing.